Hey everybody, say hello to the new camera setup. This is in my very first house and I'm very excited. In this video, we're gonna learn about object arrays, how to make an array of objects in Java. But first, if you wanna learn everything you need to know about Java, I built a full online course for you. It's helped a lot of people so far, so if you wanna check it out, the link's in the description. So let's start learning about object arrays in Java by making a new Java project. We'll call it object array, hit finish, and then in source, we'll make a class. We'll call it object array, hit the public static void main checkbox and hit finish. To make an object array in Java, you need to have an object to start off with. And in the end, it's gonna look just like this, just like a regular array, except we'll have like an object here. We'll call it something, my object array, and then it's equal to the objects inside, like object one, object two, etc. Let's say we have a monkey object. Let's make a monkey class. To create a class, you just type class and then the name. In this case, we'll call it monkey. And a class is just a blueprint for an object, meaning it has variables and methods. One variable we could put for monkey is maybe the type, which would be maybe a string. And we'll set this one to like spider monkey, for example. And classes can also have methods. Maybe our method will be ooh ah ah. Say ooh ah ah. The reason we're doing static void here is just to have some default keywords that are easy to work with. And all this method is going to do is print out ooh ah ah, because monkeys make that sound. So we've got our monkey class. Now we can start making monkey objects and then throwing them into our monkey object array. Finally. So we'll just type, we're gonna have an array of monkeys. We're gonna call it just monkeys. And then in here is the list of monkey objects that we're gonna put in the array. Just like how you make an integer array like this, call it like nums, is equal to like some numbers here. Just like how these numbers are integers, so they match up. So for example, if this didn't match, we'd get an error. We've got to have matching monkey objects to go in this monkey array. So we've got to make them. One thing you could do is do like new monkey like this, like that. But you can't really keep track of like so many of those. So we're gonna store those into names. So we're gonna have maybe like a monkey called M1 is a new monkey. And then we'll have, for the sake of arrays needing multiple, we'll just do monkey 2 and monkey 3 together. Now all we have to do is just add them into our monkey array just like this. All arrays work the same, guys. No matter if it's integers, doubles, floats, longs, booleans, or objects. So now, theoretically, what we could do is we could loop through all these monkey objects, just like how you loop through any other array. You could use a for each loop. We'll say for each monkey object inside of monkeys, we'll do something with it. We could say m dot ooh, say ooh ah. So if we save and run this now, we get each monkey's ooh ah ah. Now let's walk through line by line exactly how this works, okay? So when we click the green run button, we run code inside of the main method. The first three lines of code here are creating new monkey objects. Since we see monkey here, it needs to know where's the monkey class? It just so happens that we have a monkey class up here. A class just has variables and methods. We see one variable here. It's a string type called spider monkey. And we have a method down here that says say ooh ah ah. So it's a working class, which means we can make objects from it. So we make three monkey objects. Next, we create an array of monkeys. The reason we know it's an array of monkey objects is because that name is right here, followed by some square brackets. The name of this array is called monkeys, and then we throw each of those inside. Finally, we hit this for loop. This syntax means for each monkey object it sees inside of the monkeys array, It'll call the current monkey M and then run the code inside of here. For the first case inside of the monkeys array, we go to M1. M1 is now M, and we do m.sayooah, which is why we get that here, because that code is run here and just gets printed out. We go to the top and do the same for M2 and M3, and then we're done. So that's basically it. I don't want to make this too long. You create an array of objects just like an array of integers or anything else. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and have a great rest of your day.